Hey everybody, I want to share with you how you can create better assignments in Google Classroom. So let's give you four tips. Tip number one is going through and adding emojis to your directions. So as you can see here, this is a simple article summary, and I'm adding emojis as bullet points for things to stand out. These are often the scaffolds and supports that our students need to pay attention to key instructions. So how did I do it? Well, here's a sample assignment that I'm constructing right now. And I have this Chrome extension rep here. It's called Joy Pixels Emoji Keyboard. I could go through and type in something that I feel that would help students pay attention. So this is called, it says Research the Universal Design for Learning Framework. So I'm actually going to create a book. And as you can see, it automatically pastes it in there for me. So I'm just going to paste it right here. Construct. So let's see if I can find one for building. So I'm going to maybe do maybe a tool. All right. Oh, here we go. So this would be great. Pop that right there. So notice wherever my cursor is, that's where my emoji is going to go. So I'd go through and I would add that. So item number two is no more than three attachments. If you get too attached or too attachment crazy, students can sometimes get lost. So here's an example. This is a template that I've created of instructions that I'm going to put in my assignment. So the students are going to create this essay. So I'm going to go right here and I'm going to add from Google Drive my UDL essay. And as I'm doing that, I'm going to make this view only. So we'll just add that right here, and we'll make it view only so students can see. Now, what I may want to consider is adding no more than three different attachments so that students don't get confused. But what if I need more attachments? What could I do? Well, here's a little trick for you. So when I'm going through my essay, I have suggested steps right here that I want my students to take. And one of those steps is brainstorming what they already know, brainstorming what they need to know, and then constructing a five-paragraph essay. So I developed this template right here that, well, maybe some of them use and maybe some of them don't. I want to give them that flexibility. So I can, instead of attaching this as a link in Google Classroom, I can merely add it as a hyperlink right here in Google Docs so that my students can use it if they need it. But this is actually a really neat trick. I can go right up here to share. I can change this so that anyone with the link can either view or edit. Doesn't matter. I'm just going to go ahead and hit copy. When I put this in my document, as you can see here, I'm going to go Command K and paste this in. When I click on this, it's just going to take me to the template that I already made. And so students would then have to go up to File and make a copy. That can be a little confusing. So here's a little trick for you to make things force a copy for students. So I'm going to go back to this link. And I'm going to, once again, create a link. And I'm going to paste. And I'm going to delete all the way up to the word edit. And I'm going to type in the word copy. When I hit Apply, check out what happens. It forces students to make a copy of the template and saves it right in their Google Drive. So that might be a great way to help manage more than three links. Another thing that could be helpful too is if you have hyperlinks in your document, change the font and change the size. So this is an Arial 11. Let's change it to Arial 14 and let's change it to yellow highlighted just so that students know that it's a link. And then last but not least, what else could I do? Well, I could actually go through and create a quick screencast, sort of like you're seeing right here, with Screencastify giving instructions on how to complete this essay. I put that video right here, so there's a sample, and I might put that as an attachment. So let's show you what I did on YouTube.
Hey everybody, so we are going to complete a UDL essay.
So I could put this link right here in as an attachment. So I'm going to add, once again, something from YouTube. And I can just paste the link right up here, pop it in, and assign. And so those are three ways that you can make better assignments in Google Classroom. So one, add emojis. Two, don't get too attached. Add no more than three attachments. And three, add a screencast to give instructions to your students because let's face it, they got a lot going on and so do parents, and it's a great way to not have to repeat yourself over and over again.